April 2004 was the period when everyone was discussing the possibility of terrorist acts in Britain. Those were said to involve the usage of a so-called dirty bomb. The reagent that was supposed to represent the dirty part of it is osmium tetroxide. In this video, I'll show you what this dangerous reagent is all about. This ampoule contains 3 grams of osmium tetroxide. Osmium tetroxide is very expensive and very toxic. It is the most toxic metal oxide. At 40 degrees Celsius, this reagent is already melting, turning into a pale yellow liquid. Here I am melting it with a blast of hot air. When osmium tetroxide is cooled down, it instantly crystallizes. Thanks to a high-speed camera, we can watch this process in slow-mo. Osmium tetroxide is volatile, it sublimes at room temperature. I left a crystal of this reagent in the open, and you can see that it's decreasing in volume rather quickly. Also, it gives off a smell similar to that of chlorine. Before we move on to explosive reactions, I'll show you a few qualitative reactions for determination of osmium. We'll take a highly diluted solution with osmium, acidify it with nitric acid, and add some potassium thiocyanate to it. When we extract the result with diethyl ether, we can see the ether turn blue. The sensitivity of this reaction is 1 microgram per milligram. Osmium is the only metal from platinum group that provides this blue color. Platinum provides this reaction with red color. The reaction led by regolol allows to detect 10 micrograms per milligram of osmium that gains the blue color of the mixture. A osmium tetroxide reacts with double bonds to form cyclic osmide diesters, which can then be hydrolyzed to provide vicinal diols in good yields. In the reaction with cesium hydroxide solution, osmium tetroxide forms cesium dihydroxotetroxosmate. Osmium tetroxide is a strong oxidizer, and it forms bromine from hydrobromic acid with ease. Molten osmium tetroxide ignites various materials or even explodes on contact with them. To showcase these type of reactions, I'll put a few crystals of osmium tetroxide in a small test tube and melt them with hot water. I'll also put a piece of potassium on top. Now, when osmium tetroxide is melted, it turned into a highly reactive and very dangerous substance. And here is the reaction with white phosphorus. What do you think, guys? Is that phosphorus covered in osmium or is it something else? Let me know in the comments. Phenylhydrazine instantly ignites on contact with liquid osmium tetroxide. And this is what happens if we add a little bit of lithium aluminum hydride to it. To figure out whether this black coating is osmium or not, I dropped all that's left of the tube in hydrochloric acid. Now osmium doesn't dissolve in hydrochloric acid, but most of the black coating did, quite quickly. So, what does this coating consist of? What do you think? Thanks for watching, guys, and special thanks to my dear patrons who make these expensive experiments a reality. You too can support me on Patreon by following the link in the description. See you in the next video.